Hi there, I'm Dave Householder, and I am blessed to be your Bible teacher today on the World Wide Well. I'm hiking up at Mount Laguna, east of San Diego, in the mountains, 6,000 feet above the doo-doo. And I'm here to talk to you about 1 Peter 2. And 1 Peter 2 has an awful lot to do with what's going on in the world right now, because we have a lot of people protesting all kinds of different things. All kinds of different things. If you look at the world news, there's protests going on everywhere. And the question is, when do you resist against the government? 1 Peter 2 basically says almost never. And what he says is that we should honor the king, love God, be a good neighbor, be good to people, and understand that the government is there to punish bad people and to reward good people. So do good things, basically what he says. Now, the truth is, there's a lot of tension in the Bible. And in Acts 5:29, John and Peter say, we must obey God rather than human authority. In other words, there's a time to resist. And in the book of Ecclesiastes, it says, for everything, there is a season. So how are you supposed to know whether to follow the rules or resist the rules? How can you tell when to do which? How can you tell when it's a time to stand up against the government? And how can you tell when it's a time to obey the government? Well, that's where we need two things. We need the Holy Spirit to guide us directly, and we also need the Christian community to work these things out together. We need to pray about it together. We need to seek the Lord together and ask each other, what do you think? Is this a time to follow the rules or not? And basically, unless things are really, really bad, it is a good idea to follow the rules because disorder hurts people. And so we want to create order in a society. Of course, if we're living under a Stalin or a Hitler, there comes a time to say, I'm just not going to do what you're trying to make me do. So basically, people say, well, hey, there's these contradictions in the Bible, so that must be proof that the Bible's not true. I think the exact opposite is true. The tension in the Bible is the real life tension we live in. There's all kinds of tension in the Bible. And Martin Luther, 500 years ago, said that's what brings the Bible alive for him. He was asked, can you lose your salvation? He said, yes and no. Are we saints or sinners, believers? Well, we are both saints redeemed by Jesus, and yet we still sin. Is there such a thing as predestination? Yes and no. And that's the tension we live in. So go ahead and just embrace that tension, but do it with other people and do it with the Holy Spirit. We make our biggest mistakes all by ourselves. That's why you need me and I need you, and we all need each other. And we all need this beautiful creation all around me that God has given us. So that's the good news from Mount Laguna in California, and I will talk to you again tomorrow.